And this question, it is given that one end of a copper rod of length 1 meter and area for section 10 raised to minus 3 meter square is immersed in boiling water and the other end in ice. If the coefficient of thermal conductivity of copper is 92 calorie per meter per second per degree Celsius and the latent heat of ice is 18 to 10 raised to 4 calorie per gram kilogram, then the amount of ice which will melt in 1 minute is. So over here we are considering a conductor and one end of copper and copper rod and conductor of length which we can take as 1 meter, and area of cross section, its area of cross section is given as something, but let's say A is equal to 10 raised to minus 3 meter square, is immersed in boiling water. So one end we can just consider that it's maintained at a temperature of 100 degrees Celsius. And the other end is in ice. So other end is in contact with ice. We can take it as at 0 degree Celsius. The coefficient of thermal conductivity of copper rod is, so the value of K is given as nothing but 92 calorie per meter per second per degree Celsius. So we can write this as 92 calorie. We can just convert into joules, so because we are going to do each and everything in SI system, so 92 into we can take it as 4.2 joules, and the latent heat of ice, we can take it as the latent heat of ice is given as nothing but 8 into 10 raised to 4 calorie per kilogram, so we can write this as 8 into 10 raised to 4 into 4.2 joules per kilogram. The amount of ice which will melt in 1 minute is. So first we can find out how much amount of heat energy is flowing through this conductor in a time of 1 minute or in a time of 60 second. So if we are using this equation, dq divided by dt is equal to ka delta t divided by L. We can write in a time of t seconds if there is q amount of heat energy is flowing. So we can write this as equal to q by t. So first try to find out the value of Q. So we can write Q is equal to Ka into the value of delta T, difference in temperature, divided by, we can take it as dT or difference in temperature delta T, divided by length into time, let's say that is equal to T. Now by using this heat energy, this ice is going to convert it into water. So we can write Rm is to find out the mass of ice which is converted into water. So let's imagine that that is equal to M, and latent heat of fusion of ice, take it as something but LF. So we can find out the value of M over here, which is equal to K into A into delta T into T divided by L and latent heat of fusion. Now we can just substitute the values over here. The value of K is given as something but 92 into 10 raised to 92 into 4.2. The value of area cross section is given as 10 raised to minus 3. The value of delta T, difference in temperature, is nothing but 100. And time is 1 minute, which we can take as 60 seconds. We need to put all the values in SI system. And the value of length of conductor is given as nothing but 1. And latent heat of fusion, we can it is also given, that is equal to 8 into 10 raised to 4 into 4.2. So we can cancel this 4.2 and this 4.2, and we can further calculate to find out the value of mass M. So we'll get the answer of M as nothing but 6.9 into 10 raised to minus 3. That much we are doing all the calculations in SI system. So we'll get the answer in kilogram.